Welcome and thank you for joining me in today's video. We will talk about the hypergeometric distribution. Get ready to watch how it can be applied through the following real-life examples. 32 applicants, 14 women and 18 men apply for a job. 8 of the applicants are randomly sampled. What is the probability that 3 of them are women? Among the top 50 oil and gas companies around the world, 7 of them are headquartered in the United States. If 4 companies are selected from the previous top 50 list, what is the probability that one or more of them are headquartered in the United States? A mobile phone manufacturer produces and ships to a smartphone retailer 100 smartphones, knowing that 5 of them are dead on arrival. The retailer is going to randomly check 10 of the devices. What is the probability that the retailer will find one or more defective devices? A bag contains 15 red marbles and 5 blue marbles. You randomly select 5 marbles without replacement. What is the probability that exactly 3 of the marbles selected are red? A population of 50 people contains 10 engineers and 40 non-engineers. A sample of 15 people is selected randomly without replacement. What is the probability that exactly 5 people in the sample are engineers? What do these examples have in common? They can be modeled by a discrete distribution. What do we mean by the term discrete distribution? We refer to a distribution describing random variables that can take on a countable number of distinct values. In these examples, we have a fixed number of trials that have 2 possible outcomes, success or failure. We try to model the probability of X number of successes occurring in a fixed number of trials, N, where the trials are selected without a replacement from a population. However, as the sampling is done without replacement, the probability of success in each successive trial changes. This is why we need additional information about the population makeup. In other words, besides the sample size, we need 2 more parameters, such as the population size and the number of successes in the population. Anybody can wonder, as we have a discrete distribution with a fixed number of trials and successes, why do we not apply the binomial probability formula? The binomial probability formula is used when trials are independent and the probability of success remains constant. For example, the probability of getting heads when flipping a coin does not depend on previous flips. In the cases discussed here, however, the sampling is done without replacement, meaning the probability of success changes on each trial. That's the reason why the binomial distributions may tend to overestimate the hypergeometric probability, especially when the sample size is large compared to the population size. Before we proceed to the hypergeometric formula, we first define capital N as the size of the population, lowercase n as the sample size, k as the number of successes in the population, and x as the number of successes in the sample. The formula for the probability mass function of the hypergeometric distribution is k choose x times n minus k choose lowercase n minus x, and we divide this product by capital N choose lowercase n. However, what do we mean by k choose x? We mean the number of ways of picking x items from k items, where k is equal or higher than x. The first term, k choose x, is the number of ways to choose x items with a desired feature from a population of k items with that feature. The second term, n minus k choose n minus x, is the number of ways to choose n minus x items without the desired feature from a population of size n minus k that does not contain the desired feature. So in total, the numerator contains all the successful combination of outcomes between the number of ways to choose the items with desired feature and number of ways to choose the remaining items of the sample that contain the non-desired feature drawn without replacement from a larger population they belong. The denominator shows the total number of ways of drawing a sample of n from the population without replacement. Therefore, by dividing the number of successful outcomes by the total number of possible outcomes, we can calculate the probability according to the hypergeometric distribution. To understand how this formula can be applied, let's consider the following example. In a job application process, 32 applicants, 14 of whom are women and 18 of whom are men, are considered. If 8 applicants are randomly selected, what is the probability that 3 of them will be women? If we can apply the hypergeometric formula, we find that the probability is equal to 29.65%. As you can see, the hypergeometric distribution formula includes 3 binomial coefficients, also known as combination numbers, which represent the number of ways to choose a certain number of items from a larger set of items without regard to the order in which the items are chosen. We have created a special video that shows you how to calculate the output of these binomial coefficients, both by hand and using Microsoft Excel. The first binomial coefficient is 14 choose 3, and shows the number of ways we can pick 3 women of our sample out of 14 women of the entire population. The second combination, 18 choose 5, depicts the number of ways we can pick 5 men in our sample out of the entire population, which includes 18 men. With the same logic, the last coefficient shows the number of ways we can select a sample of 8 applicants out of a population of 32 applicants. Now let's discuss the mean and variance of the hypergeometric distribution. The mean or expected value of successful outcomes is calculated by dividing the sample size by the population size and multiplying this result by the number of successful outcomes in the entire population. The logic is simple. We expect k successful outcomes over the entire population, so the number of successful outcomes in the sample is determined by the size of the sample in relation to the population. The formula for the variance of the hypergeometric distribution describes how spread out the possible values of the random variable x are likely to be. We are not going to discuss it further because it is a complex formula. However, it can be observed that as the sample size n gets closer to n capital, the variance decreases. Now, instead of struggling with the intricacies of the hypergeometric distribution formulas, we can leverage the power of Excel to quickly and easily generate the results we desire. So here we are, we have opened up Excel. Let's make our calculations easily using the Excel formulas. Let's repeat again the data for our example. In a population of 32 applicants, we have 14 women. What is the probability that we have exactly 3 women out of a sample of 8 applicants? Let's use the hypergeometric distribution formula to make our calculations. So we start typing the equal sign, hypergeom.dist, we open a bracket. The first argument is the number of successes in the sample, that is equal to 3. The second argument is the sample size, that is equal to 8. The third argument is the number of successes over the entire population. The letter S stands for successes, not for sample. So the number of successes over the entire population is equal to 14. The fourth argument is the population number, that is equal to 32. And there is a last, a fifth argument, that is to determine whether we want to calculate the individual or the cumulative probability. So here we want to estimate the individual probability, and we will type the value of 0. We close bracket, and so our result is equal to 29.65%, and it is exactly the same as before, as exactly consistent to the calculations we made before. Now, let's make our calculations. For all the potential number of women over the entire sample, so the sample size is equal to 8, so we can have a number of women equal to 0 to 8. So let's make our calculations. We start typing again the equal sign, hypergeom.dist. The first argument is the number of successes over the sample, and it is equal to 0. The second argument is the sample size, that is equal to 8. Let's lock it in order to copy the formula for the other values. the population, the success over the entire population are equal to 14. We look the cell B3 again. The number, the population size is equal to 32, and its location is in the cell B2, and let's look it. And the last argument is to determine if we want a cumulative or an individual probability, and the individual probability is represented by the number of value of 0. So we type 0 and we close the bracket. So here is the probability, and let's copy the formula for the other values of successes over the sample. Here we are. Let's repeat the same process to estimate the cumulative probabilities. So we copy the formula, but here the last argument is not 0, is equal to 1. And here is the cumulative probability for all the values. So the cumulative probability for two women is equal to 20.71% and is equal to the individual probability for 0, 1 and 2 women in our sample. Let's check this. And we generate the same result. Let's make a graphical representation of these results. So we can insert a combo chart. The individual probabilities can be represented by clustered columns, and the cumulative ones can be represented by a line. However, let's insert a secondary axis for the cumulative probabilities, because the maximum cumulative probability is equal to 100%, whereas the maximum individual probability is close to 30%, so we need a secondary axis. Here is the output. Let's change the horizontal axis, because it considers that the first value is 1, whereas in our example the first value is equal to 0, because we can have 0 women in our sample. So let's change it. Right click, select data, and here is the axis label range. Here we are. Let's make the chart bigger. Let's delete the grid lines, the legend. Let's insert a title like Hypergeometric Distribution. And let's make it bold. Let's change the color of the bars to a darker blue, so as to have a better contrast. And let's add axis titles. So here we have the number of women. Here we have the cumulative probability. And here we have the individual probability. Let's add data labels for the individual probabilities. So we select a bar, we right click, add data labels. Here we are. If we ask what is the expected number of women in the sample, you can imagine that the expected number is between 3 and 4, because here these bars have the greater value. So let's make our calculation. The expected value is equal to the sample size divided by the population size, and we multiply this by the number of successes over the entire population, and here we are. The expected value is equal to 3.5, somewhere between here. So I think we have a very nice chart. And if you liked the content of this video, please do not forget to hit the subscribe button. Thank you very much for watching.